الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن شاء الله تعالى ستارت سورة الحاقة سورة نمبر 69. سورة الحاقة سورة نمبر 69. Before we start, إن شاء الله we should be reminded these days for the blessed days of the Hijjah. أفضل أيام الدنيا, the best days of one's life. No like of these days by the hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيها أحب إلى الله تعالى من هذه الأيام. There's no days. The good deeds are more beloved to Allah سبحانه وتعالى than these days. They said, ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله, even الجهاد في سبيل الله, even he said عليه الصلاة والسلام الجهاد في سبيل الله, except a man خرج بنفسي ومالي فلم يرجع من ذلك بشيء. Except a man that left, set out himself for the jihad في سبيل الله with his own self and his wealth, and he did not return with any of these. And what that means is, الجهاد في سبيل الله in other than these days, versus the good deeds in these days, the good deeds in these days are more rewardable from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the jihad fi sabilillah in other than these days. So this is a great virtue. So that includes all the good deeds. There's no specific action except for those for hajj. They do hajj and more. And they have the best of the places and the best of times. So we have the sharaf of al-zaman, the honor of the time. And then you add to it sharaf al-makan for those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy for them to go for hajj. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us also among those who receive the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to do the good deeds. Surah Al-Haqqa, as we heard, it's number 69, Surah Al-Haqqa, and it's 52 verses. It's a Makki surah. It was said to be revealed after Surah Al-Mulk. After Surah Al-Mulk. And it's called Al-Haqqa, and some of the books they call it Surah As-Silsila, but because the word As-Silsila is mentioned, but Al-Haqqa, this is what it's well known, because it's mentioned in the beginning of the surah, one of the names of the Day of Judgment. One of the names of the Day of Judgment, as we will see, inshallah ta'ala. And it's a surah that talks about the Day of Judgment, and the day that everything is created and everything that we do in this life is for the Day of Judgment, for the hereafter, and the everlasting life after this life, and the way the people would be, and the different types of people according to their actions. So this is a glad tidings for the believers, warnings for the disbelievers, and the more of the warnings of what's going to be in the Day of Judgment, which is very near, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in the Quran in many, many verses. So we'll start inshallah ta'ala with reading the beginning verses inshallah. So أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحاقة. الحاقة. ما الحاقة. وما أدراك ما الحاقة. كذبت ثمود وعاد بالقارعة. كذبت ثمود وعاد بالقارعة. فأما ثمود فأهلكوا بالطاغية.
ثمود فأهلكوا بالطاغية.
فأما ثمود فأهلكوا بالطاغية. وأما عاد فأهلكوا بريح صرصر عاتية. وأما عاد فأهلكوا بريح صرصر عاتية. سَخَّرَهَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَبْعَ لَيَالٍ سَخَّرَهَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَبْعَ لَيَالٍ وَثَمَانِيَةَ أَيَّامٍ حُسُومًا. فترى القوم فيها صرعى فترى القوم فيها صرعى كأنهم كأنهم أعجاز نخل خاوية. فهل ترى لهم من باقية؟ فهل ترى لهم من باقية؟ We have alhaqa six counts, the longest count, mad. You have, because you have a mad, and then after it is the shadda, one of the letters of al-mad, alif wa ya, and then you have the harf, the letter after it has a shadda, which here is the qaf with a shadda. Malhaqa, the same thing. Wama adaraka, the first mad is 4 to 5 counts, and then adaraka, the dal with sukun, you make qalqala. Wama adaraka malhaqa, 6 counts. Kadhabat thamudu, the ta with sukun has to be pronounced. And then you have the tha, so they both close from where you say it. So you have to make sure that you don't make idgham. You don't say kadhabat thamudu or kadhabat thamud. Kadhabat thamud. Thamudu wa adum bil qari'a, tanween after it ba. So this is iqlab, the meme sound. Fa amma thamudu mim shadda. Fa uhliku bil taghiya. Bil taghiya, the ta is heavy. وأما عاد إخفاء عاد ف فأهلكوا بريح here also إدغام but the difference is in the sound of the غنة the second one is heavy because the صاد is heavy بريح صرصر عاتية and the last one is إظهار سخرها make sure that the خاء is heavy سخرها عليهم سبع ليال دباء وثقلقلة سبع ليالي تنوين أفتلت واو إدغام وضغنة وثمانية أيام حسومة هيز إظهار نغن فترى القوم فيها صرعى صرعى the ra is heavy because of the sad the مفتوح صرعى كأنهم نون الشدة أعجاز نخل خاوية أعجاز نخل خاوية هي الإظهار فهل ترى لهم من باقية two memes and then you have إقلاب من باقية so the first word which is الحاقة and this is one of the names of the day of judgment which is the الحاقة the reality that's very important thing to have this meaning in our heart. One of the names of the Day of Judgment, that this is the haqq, this is the reality. This is why we're here on the face of earth. We're not here for anything else except for al-haq. For the reality of this life is the day of judgment, is the hereafter. And that's why the word al-haqa is, in Arabic, it's siqat fa'il from haqqa shay. Haqqa shay, not the truth, but haqqa shay, that means when something happened, when something is established, when something is real. So this is, when you say haqqa shay, that means the matter is already established. Something that, whether it's an incident or something, like when you say something like this, al-haqqa, linguistically, it's either one of two meanings. The first one is that refers to an incident. Haqqa shay, that something happened, something is established. The second thing is from the same word, haqqa al-haqq. The haqq, the truth, is established also. So the haqq, before it happens, the believers, they know that this is the haqq. And then once it becomes reality to everyone, when it's too late, for example, the disbelievers, they would see that it's haqq. But it's too late for them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He says, لِيُحِقَّ الْحَقَّ وَيُبْطِلَ الْبَاطِلِ. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the haqq haqq and to make the batil batil, even though the haqq is haqq, but for humanity to see it, because not everybody sees the haqq. So when the believers are victorious, when the deen is established and they defeat their enemies, this is where the haqq is established. Before that, the haqq is still there, but no one can defeat it whatsoever. So this is what haqq al-shay means. So the Imam Sa'di rahimahullah, he said, Al-Haqqa min asma'i yawm al-qiyamah, from the names of yawm al-qiyamah. لِأَنَّهَا تَحِقُّ وَتَنْزِلُ بِالْخَلْقِ, because it becomes a reality. So again, you see the relationship between the reality and the truth. The truth, before it happens, if you say to someone in that other room over there is so-and-so is sitting there. To me, I know that. So this is, to me, this is the truth. But for it to be a reality to someone that didn't see him, if they see him or they believe me. So once they see him, once he comes out from the room, then it's a reality. So it's reality to them, even though it's a real thing. So therefore, لِأَنَّهَا تَحِقّ. So the day of judgment is haqq and it's going to happen. And it's the reality that is going to be established. وَتَنْزِلُ الْخَلْقِ. It comes upon the people, upon the creation of Allah. وَتَظْهَرُ فِيهَا حَقَائِقُ الْأُمُورِ. And the حَقَائِقُ الْأُمُورِ, the reality of matters, the right from wrong, the who's right and who's wrong, and all of these things will become apparent, will become clear. And as very simple is, what is in the Day of Judgment? Al-Wa'd wal-Wa'id. As Ibn Kathir rahimahullah said, Al-Wa'd is the promise of Allah, and Al-Wa'id is the warnings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we receive in this life. The wa'd, the promise that in the day of judgment, the believers will enter Jannah. And the wa'id is that the disbelievers, the sinners, will enter the hellfire. So al-haqqa is when al-wa'd wal-wa'id becomes established. When the promise, the reality of the promise is there. So it's not just a promise anymore, it's the reality of it. So وَتَظَّرُ فِيهَا حَقَائِقُ الْأُمُورِ وَمُخَبَّآتِ الصُّدُورِ. He says in the tafsir, and what's hidden in the sudur, in the hearts. And then it becomes apparent in the day of judgment. فَعَظَّمَ تَعَالَى شَأْنَهَا وَفَخَّمَهَا. So as a result of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exalted the day of judgment. And فَخَّمَهُ from a tafkhim, you know, tafkhim is to make something heavy. So the same thing. وَبِمَا كَرَّرَهُ, because it's repeated, as mentioned before in the verses, that you have this repetition of the same thing. Like الْقَارِعَ مَا الْقَارِعَ وَمَا أَدْرَكَ مَا الْقَارِعَ and the like of this. Why is that? So that it becomes big, because it's big. It is big. There's nothing bigger than the Day of Judgment. But to him, when we're sitting like this, and comfortably, when we talk about al-haqq on the Day of Judgment, you know, where is the reality of that in the hearts? Forgive me. So the way of the Quran is to get these hearts to wake up. Right? So al-haqqatu mal-haqqa, wama adraka mal-haqqa. So we have to make our hearts according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from it to be. wants to make that tafkhim, that ta'zeem, to the day of judgment, that it occupies everything. So all of our speech and actions is according to this. What's going to be then in the day of judgment, what we said, what we did, according to the shara, to the deen of Allah. So فَعَظَّمَ تَعَالَى شَأْنَهَا وَفَخَّمَهُ بِمَا كَرَّهُ مِنْ قَوْلِ الْحَاقَةُ مَا الْحَاقَةُ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْحَاقَةُ فَإِنَّ لَهَا شَأْنًا عَظِيمًا. Because indeed it has a great shan, shan, affair, matters. وَهَوْلًا جَسِيمًا. Al-hawl is the horrors of it. And it's jaseeman, big. وَمِنْ عَظَمَتِهَا أَنَّ اللَّهَ أَهْلَكَ الْأُمَمَ الْمُكَذِّبَ بِهَا بِالْعَذَابِ الْعَاجِلِ. And from this greatness of the day of judgment, that Allah destroyed nations before because they denied the day of judgment. Because they disbelieved in the day of judgment, Allah punished them in this life before the hereafter. As a result of this, the greatness of this day. So that's why الحق ما الحق, what is الحق وما أدراك ما الحق, and what do you know about الحق. Then the ayat afterwards comes to describe some of the things in the day of judgment. So again, why this is there? التهويل, to make that تهويل. So as a ibadah, as we mentioned before, when you read something like الحق, the ibadah in the heart should be to make تعظيم of it, to see how great, to bring that greatness in the heart. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Most High, is saying it the way we heard it. Even though it's sufficient to just say one thing. Al-haqqatu ma al-haqqa wa ma adraka ma al-haqqa. And what do you know about al-haqqa? We only know what's in the wahi revelation from Allah. So then he says, after that, كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ وَعَادٌ بِالْقَارِعَةِ. ثمود and عاد, they disbelieved, they denied القارعة, the striking hour of the judgment. So if you, the first three verses, الحاقة ما الحاقة وما أدراك ما الحاقة, this is done with the meaning of الحاقة. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كذبت ثمود وعاد بالقارعة. So ثمود and عاد, they denied, they disbelieved in القارعة. القارعة, one also of the names of the day of judgment. So, and if you make them, of course, they're all together one after the other. So, this is, then it shows what happened to those who disbelieve in al-haq. So that's why he says, ثُمَّ ذَكَرَ نَمُوذَجًا. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned نَمُوذَجًا. النَّمُوذَج, and some they would call it al-unmuذَج, is the, in the worldly life, is the prototype. But that's in the business world. Like you have something that you make to show the people what's gonna be manufactured. So a namudaj is an example. He gave something that is very real, very clear. من أحوالها الموجودة في الدنيا المشاهدة فيها. Something that you can relate to in this life, that you can see in this life of what's going to be. You have an idea of what's going to be in the hereafter. Even though it's nothing compared to what the reality of it is. Because nobody's seen the like of the Day of Judgment. وَهُوَ مَا أَحَلَّهُ مِنَ الْعُقُوبَاتِ الْبَلِيغَةِ بِالْأُمَمِ الْعَتِيَةِ. Which is what Allah did to the, as a punishment for the mighty nations before. So therefore, from we learn from this, that things in this life, when it happens, it's supposed to give us a reminder of how things will be in the Day of Judgment. So if there is a punishment, we remember the punishment in the hereafter. If there is a reward, we remember the reward in the hereafter. And when we see destruction, we remember the destruction in the Day of Judgment. So all of that is decreed for, one of the great wisdom behind it is for people to remember the Day of Judgment, to see it as an example, as a way to see something that they would see in the Day of Judgment. Even sometimes when they see, great horror, they would say it's like as if it's the Day of Judgment. Because of the severity of it. So, كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودِ. ثَمُود disbelieved, denied. وَهُمُ الْقَبِيلَةُ الْمَشْهُورَةُ سُكَّانَ الْحِجْرِ الَّذِينَ أَرْسَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ رَسُولَهُ صَالِحًا عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. ثَمُود, the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them, صالح عليه السلام. يَنْهَاهُمْ عَمَّا هُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ الشِّرْكِ. صالح عليه السلام, he forbade these people from a shirk, associating partners with Allah. وَيَأْمُرُهُمْ بِالتَّوْحِيدِ, and he commands them to be upon the tawheed. فَرَدُّوا دَعْوَتَهُ وَكَذَّبُوا. وَكَذَّبُوهُ. So they rejected his da'wah. رَدُّوا دَعْوَتَهُ وَكَذَّبُوهُ. And they disbelieved in him, denied him. وَكَذَّبُوا مَا أَخْبَرَهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. And they disbelieved in what he informed them of the Day of Al-Qiyamah. And this is always the message of the prophets. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Do not associate partners of Allah. Because if you don't, the punishment in the hereafter is the hellfire, the everlasting place for the disbelievers. And the Jannah for those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, وَهِيَ الْقَارِعَةَ الَّتِي تَقْرَعُ الْخَلْقِ كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ وَعَادٌ بِالْقَارِعَةَ الْقَارِعَةَ is what تَقْرَعَ الْخَلْقِ is strikes the people. الْقَارِعَةَ comes from striking. بِأَهْوَالِهَا by its horrors also. So it strikes them. وَكَذَلِكَ عَاد الْأُولَى the people of عَاد سُكَّان حَضْرَمَوْت those who lived in حَضْرَمَوْت in Yemen حِينَ بَعَثَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِمْ رَسُولَهُ هُودًا عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ هُودًا وَسَنْتُ to them. يدعوهم إلى عبادة الله وحده فكذبوه وكذبوا بما أخبر به. So they disbelieved in him and they disbelieved in what he informed them of al-ba'ath, the resurrection. فأهلك الله الطائفتين بالهلاك المعجل. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed both tribes and both people with an immediate punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ وَعَادٌ بِالْقَارِعَةِ And the one tafsir of al-qari'ah is what? The day of judgment still. Because some of the ulama, they mention, which is, it's okay to give more than one meaning to it, and it's not contradicting. As we said, one verse can mean more than one thing, and they're all correct. They all give beautiful meanings. So some mention that al-qari'ah is what strikes the heart. So whether it's in something in this life, so the punishment in this life, and some said that the ayat of the Quran or the wahi from Allah, that they disbelieved in the wahi, and the wahi is supposed to strike the heart, right? So when they disbelieved in what's supposed to strike the heart with the wa'd and al-wa'id, then they were punished in this life and in the hereafter. So as we know, the details of the story of Ad and Thamud. كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ وَعَادٌ بِالْقَارِعَةِ But we'll take here what's mentioned about Al-Qari'ah, which is the Day of Judgment. فَأَمَّا ثَمُودُ فَأُهْلِكُوا بِالطَّاغِيَةِ As for Thamud, they were destroyed by the awful cry. فَأُهْلِكُوا بِالطَّاغِيَةِ And الطَّاغِيَةِ here is وَهِيَ الصَّيْحَةُ الْعَظِيمَةُ الْفَضِيعَةِ الصَّيْحَة, the shout that was عَظِيمَة, great, and فَضِيعَة, horrific one. And imagine people dies from a shout. What kind of a shout that is? A loud voice that caused people to die. التي انصدعت منها قلوبهم, their hearts split as a result of this صيحة. وزهقت لها أرواحهم, and their souls, you know, came out of their bodies. They died. فأصبحوا موتى لا يرى إلا مساكنهم وجثثهم. They became all dead. Only their houses were in place, and they would see the bodies of the people of Thamud. فَأَمَّا ثَمُودُ فَأُهْلِكُوا بِالطَّاغِيَةِ So either الطَّاغِيَةِ, which is a صَيْحَة, which is mentioned in other parts of the Quran, or it refers to the act that was طَاغِيَةً, that transgressed all limits of punishments, meaning it's beyond one's imagination, which is also the الصَّيْحَة. So, and it's okay also to mention الطَّاغِيَةِ, meaning the transgression, which is sins, disbelieving in Allah, that's what destroyed them. Because that's what led to the real destruction. فَأَمَّا ثَمُودُ فَأُهْلِكُوا بِالطَّاغِيَةِ When they transgressed the limits, which is disbelieving in Allah, not following the messenger, disbelieving in the hereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them. But the first one is, again, we're taking one opinion here, which is الطَّاغِيَةِ, which is الصَّيْحَة, that is mentioned in the Quran about the people of Thamud. And this is what Imam al-Tabari rahimahullah, he took also as the opinion. فَأَمَّا ثَمُودُ فَأُهْلِكُوا بِالطَّاغِيَةِ So just to keep in mind that others said it's the dhunub, the sins, which is all correct. That al-Taghiyah refers to the sins, refers to the disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also refers to the sayha. This is how they were punished by the sayha or the shout. And because the ayah says, كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ بِطَغْوَاهَا إِذِ انْبَعَثَ أَشْقَاهَا So Thamud, they disbelieved بِطَغْوَاهَا by their transgression. So the word طُغْيَان is mentioned in Surah Al-Shams like their action of transgression. So here بالطاغية also can mean the same thing and the Quran explains itself, but also the sayha or the shout. And فأهلكوا بالطاغية, what's his name, the one that killed the camel. He destroyed them. And he was the reason for their destruction. وأما عاد فأهلكوا بريح صرصار عاتية. And as for عاد, they were destroyed by a furious, violent wind. وأما عاد فأهلكوا, they were destroyed بريح, ريح is wind. صرصر, that means it's very cold and it burns. So صرصر, he says, أي قوية شديدة الهبوب. Very strong in its strength. لها صوت أبلغ من صوت الرعد القاصف. الصرصر, it has a very strong sound, much more stronger than the sound of the thunder. عاتية, that means عتت على خزانها, على قول كثير من المفسرين. عاتية, that means it's mighty, it's very strong, that was stronger than even the keepers of the wind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it, you know, that every thing that has an angel responsible for it. So it was even stronger than the angel himself. A strong wind. The angels, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the one that command them to send the winds. So they have this power from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it's atiya even over them. عتت على خزانها, as he says, على قول كثير من المفسرين. So this is one opinion. We rarely in the tafsir of Ibn Sa'd, you take more than one opinion. But here he mentioned, first one is عتت على خزانها. That it was even tougher than those who are responsible to send the punishment. أو عتت على عاد. Or the wind was very strong and mighty over the people of عاد. وزادت على الحد. And beyond any normal storm or wind. كما هو الصحيح, as what he said is what is correct. So أما عاد فأهلكوا بريح صرصار عاتية. والصر comes from when something is very cold. And also with loud sound. So the word gives both meanings. So it's very cold and it's very loud in sound. And it's Samum brought all kinds of things and poison on them. So this is what وَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَأُهْلِكُوا بِرِيحٍ صَرْصَارٍ عَاتِيَةٍ. سخرها عليهم سبع ليال وثمانية أيام حسوما فترى القوم فيها صرعى كأنهم أعجاز نخل خاوية. Which means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which Allah imposed on them for 7 nights and 8 days in succession, so that you could see men lying overthrown, destroyed, as if they were hollow trunks of date palms. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala سخرها عليهم. التسخير, like سخر الله الشمس والقمر. So is to, when something is subjugated, is under the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this wind upon the people of Thamud, 7 layalin, 7 nights, and وثمانية أيام, and 8 days. 8 days. حسومة. الحسوم is, as he says, أي نحسن. النحس is the evil. وشرًا, and also evil, فظيعًا, very strong upon them, فدمرتهم وأهلكتهم, destroyed them completely. فترى القوم فيها صرعى, you would see the people in it صرعى. صرعى, that means هلكة, destroyed, موتى, dead, and defeated already. And when someone like that, and when someone defeats someone, فلان صرعى فلان, مصارعة, they use it for wrestling. So فترى القوم فيها صرعى, that means they're all dead. كأنهم أعجاز نخل خوية, as if they are أعجاز نخل. النخل is the palm trees. الأعجاز is the palm trees, which is the trunk, only the trunk, without the head, without anything. كأنهم جذوع النخل التي قد قطعت رؤوسها الخوية, الساقط بعضها على بعض. So uprooted, when it's uprooted from the ground and it's laying down. This is how they looked, meaning with the, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them as a result of that. So سخر عليهم سبع ليال وثمانية أيام حسوما. And حسوما also, you know, الحسم, when something is decisive, when something is established. So, and this is, that's why it was one after the other. So one day after the other, there was no, you know, when you have a storm and it's something that it stays for 7 days or something, it, you know, slow down a little bit and then it picks up again. No, it was one after, you know, without continuous one without stopping whatsoever. So without, this is one of the meaning of husuman, as it's mentioned in the tafsir. And it has many different meanings of the, of something established, something continuous, something that cuts. So this is how all of these meanings are there. So سخر عليهم سبع ليال وثمانية أيام حسومة. So so the two major meanings, متتابعات, continuous, and evil, both are correct in the word حسومة. فترى القوم في صرعة, so you would see the people in it صرعة, destroyed, كأنهم أعجاز نخل خاوية, as if they are أعجاز نخل, the جذوع, the trunk of the trees, خاوية, that means it's empty, without any heads to it. فهل ترى لهم من باقية, so which means do you see any remnants of them. فهل ترى لهم من باقية, and he says here, فهذا, وهذا استفهام بمعنى النفي المتقرر. This is a question that gives the meaning that this is denying the that with well established denial. And if do you see any of them? Of course, the answer is none. So instead of saying you don't see any of them, that means they're all destroyed. It comes with a question, so that it shows the power of what happened to them, and they used to claim to be all that, and they can push away the punishment of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. So nothing of them, none of them. Stayed or remained, but they're all destroyed. And only masakinuhum, their homes and their dwellings, to witness against them and to see the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as you see from the beginning of the surah, it shows the severity of the punishment of Allah. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his punishment comes down, no one can push that away. And that's why when people are given time and given time, they become deceived. And they think it's not going to happen to them. Till once the punishment comes, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُمْهِلُ لِلظَّالِمِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives respite to the oppressor, to the evil doer. Give him time. حَتَّى إِذَا أَخَذَهُ لَمْ يُفْلِتْ. Till when he sees him, he doesn't let him go. That means he is punished. The real punishment. And this is, as we talked about it in Surah Al-Qalam, this is one of the clear evidences that shows the justice of Allah in the punishment being an everlasting one. Because it's unlike the punishment of the human beings. The human beings, if they have authority, they have power, and if they are just and someone do evil, what's going to happen if human beings are in charge? They would take that evil man and they punish him, retaliate for him, and that's the end of this, of his evil. But the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the face of earth is different. So why? Because there is a day of judgment. The day of judgment is an everlasting punishment or everlasting happiness. So that's why the day that the way that they are treated in this life is differently. So therefore they are given time and warning after, and they are let to do evil. And the justice, according to most of the human beings, where the justice, where the justice, is an everlasting punishment. So it goes beyond any words of justice that a person can establish. If you kill them once, or if they're punished once, that's not enough for their crimes. There's not enough for their evil. That's why the day of judgment is delayed, and it's all by the wisdom of Allah, because when the punishment comes, it's an everlasting one. So that's how the surah is supposed to bring into the hearts the exaltation of the day of judgment and the nations before what happened to them. And why the nations before are mentioned? Because there's nothing new in the human beings. Everything is the same. Nothing changed whatsoever. So nations, individuals, those who transgress the limits, those who disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the punishment is going to be established upon them. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from the punishment in this life and hereafter, and to save us from the hellfire.